Hampshire has long been known as a bump in the road for front runners. And this year is no exception. The road to the Republican nomination in the White House is a long road. Mine will go through all 50 states, and I intend it to end at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
Welcome back to our Commitment 2016 primary special from the campus of St. Anselm College and the Institute of Politics. Boys, have you decided who you're voting for yet?
Not yet, Josh.
Not yet.
Yeah, we have.
The good news is there is still plenty of time. 1 year away from the New Hampshire primary, but Granite Staters are already starting to form their opinions about the possible presidential field. And here's a look at it in our latest WMUR Granite State poll. All right, joined by UNH pollster Andy Smith. Good to see you, fresh out of the field. So let's start in the Republican side of things.
Republican side, once Romney, take Romney out of the equation here, it's a really packed, tight field. Jeb Bush leading, but only at 17%, and that's not even a statistically significant lead over Scott Walker, who's in second place at 12%. Scott Walker at 12. And then after that, you really get it bunched up. Rand Paul at 9%, Mike Huckabee at 9%, Chris Christie at 9%, even Ben Carson at 8%, and then the other candidates are even lower than that. We've got a year to go. The race is really, really packed, and these candidates really haven't engaged with the voters yet.
Let's talk about name ID on the Republican side of things. Obviously, Bush is a name that people are familiar with. Romney, we know what happened there, but he's not running. Right. So what is this? What does it say regarding
this? Well, the best known candidates and the best liked candidates would be Rand Paul, Chris Christie, and a Jeb Bush, Mike Huckabee. Scott Walker actually is not as well known, but he has the best net favorability ratings. That's if you take the percent of a favorable and subtract the people who have an unfavorable opinion of him out. Best known candidate is Donald Trump, but he's also the least liked candidate by a wide margin.
Any surprises in that Republican field that you look at and say, Like Scott Walker surprises me, number two. He hasn't been in New Hampshire yet, but
Scott Walker's been getting a lot of attention among the Republican circles on the Republican radio stations on the Drudge Report and places like that. But it's not surprising that a lot of these candidates aren't well known because they haven't run before. If you look at the candidates who are the best known ones, even Chris Christie or Mike Huckabee, Rick Perry, Rick Santorum, these are people that ran before, sure. And that's why they're well known. Certainly Jeb Bush is known because he's got that Bush name after.
So it's a wide open field. All right, let's flip things over to the Democratic side of things. No surprises here. Hillary Clinton still at the top.
Hillary Clinton still at the top. She's at 58%. She's been at that level about 60% for the last couple years. She's the best known Democratic candidate. She's the best liked Democratic candidate. And she's the Democratic candidate that Democrats think is going to win the primary a year out. But she does have a couple areas of weakness. We asked some candidate qualities, which candidate best represents these things. So she's seen as the strongest leader, has the best chance of winning, has the right experience to be president. But if you ask some of these other qualities, you can show areas of weakness. Best represents Democrats like yourself, only 43% name her there. But when you ask her who's the most likable candidate, only 32% name Clinton. And who's the most believable candidate, only 31% of likely Democratic primary voters name Clinton there.
So possibly a couple of dents in the armor there. Let's talk about some of the other people in the Democratic field. Obviously they trail, but they're names that...
Joe Biden is in the single digits. Elizabeth Warren's in the single digits. She's been bumping up. She's actually interesting in that if you ask people who their first and second choice is and you add those together, she comes in second place behind Clinton there. So Warren, even though she's not running, and said she's not running, there is a strong effort among Democrats to push for her for the more progressive wing of the Democratic Party. And I think there's some traction that she would have here if she got into the race.
How about Bernie Sanders? Spent a lot of time here in New Hampshire so far. He's next door neighbor, senator from Vermont.
Bernie Sanders is seemed to be... He's not as well known as Warren. He doesn't have the same support as Warren. He's about 5% in the polls. He's still at low numbers, but you know he would be the person who that progressive vote would go for should Elizabeth Warren not run.
Right. He has been known to pack some houses of late when he's giving talks here in New Hampshire. All right, let's talk about the one thing that overrides this whole thing. We are a year away from the primary, and even though they're trailing in the polls, There's lots of room for maneuvering here.
Absolutely. I think everybody has to remember, it's a year out. Voters in New Hampshire don't make up their minds in the primary who they're going to vote for until the last few days of the election. You know, typically it's 30% or more make up their mind over the last 3 days. 15 to 20% make up their mind on election day. So these polls that we're seeing right now are nowhere predictive of what's going to happen. The only thing that we can say from these polls, Clinton's by far the front runner, no front runner on the Republican side.
And that's why we're probably going to have you do this again this year.
I hope so.
Andy, good to see you. Thanks very much.
One other interesting note, although at this point we are still pretty far away from a general election, when you look at a potential head-to-head matchup between former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, who is leading our Granite State poll among Democrats, and former Florida Governor Jeb Bush leading on the Republican side of things now that Mitt Romney is out, 51% of likely voters said that they would vote for Clinton, 39% for Bush. At this point, both parties heavily support their candidate, with 22% of independents still undecided. And when Kentucky Senator Rand Paul goes head-to-head with a potential matchup with Clinton, 50% of likely voters said they would go for Hillary Clinton, 40% for Paul.
All right, let's get back to our candidate profiles now. And he has been one of the more outspoken members of the U.S. Senate ever since his election to the body back in 2010. Joined once again by Adam Sexton, who recently sat down with one Kentucky senator, Rand Paul.
And Josh, Senator Paul is viewed as one of the more meticulous planners in this process, someone who's been at it for a while in terms of building towards a potential run for president. He has a relatively new face on the national scene, but a name that has been around for a while.
Kentucky Senator Rand Paul is aiming high, cultivating relationships and connections in New Hampshire as he thinks about running for president. For more than a year, he's been making regular visits to the Granite State, and on the stump, he frequently says it's time for the Republican Party to become more diverse.
We're going to win when we look like America. We need to be white, we need to be brown, we need to be black, we need to be with tattoos, without ponytails, with beards, without. We need to look like the rest of America.
In his first visit of 2015, Senator Paul highlighted support for the Second Amendment and opposition to the Common Core education program. The senator won his first and only election in 2010, riding a Tea Party wave of discontentment to Washington.
The reason I ran for office is I got tired of throwing things at my TV, got tired of the government spending money we don't have, borrowing $1 million a minute. I think the number one threat to our country still is an $18 trillion debt. Somebody's got to do something about it.
That message has echoes of Paul's father, Dr. Ron Paul, a former congressman and three-time candidate for president. Dr. Paul made a career of trying to hammer libertarian values into the Republican Party platform. Now the son has picked up where the father left off.
Is there a libertarian moment that's coming in American politics?
Yeah, and I think also one thing definitely in New Hampshire that's present, really present in a lot of places around the country, is sort of what I call the Leave Me Alone Coalition. People who just want to be left alone, the government to be out of their lives in many ways. And some of that you could call libertarian, some of that you could call limited government, some of that you could call constitutional conservatism. There's a lot of different words. But yeah, I think there, you know, the live free or die state has definitely a good percentage of folks who are concerned with big government.
Appearing on Close Up in January, Senator Paul defended his push for a more conservative foreign policy while also taking aim at a fellow would-be White House contender on the Democratic side, Hillary Clinton.
We maybe don't need to be in every civil war around the world, and that sometimes our involvement, particularly like Hillary's war in Libya, that involvement really in the end probably backfired. And I think we're more at risk now because Libya is a disaster and the jihadists are run amok. The jihadists swim in our swimming pool, for goodness sakes, in our embassy in Tripoli. So I think Hillary's war has actually made us more at risk and more danger.
Senator Paul says he'll make a final decision about running for president sometime in March or April. Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.
And Josh, Senator Paul, not quite as hawkish on foreign policy as the rest of the potential presidential field on the Republican side. That could be an area where we see some fireworks early in this race.
And yet another candidate with generational ties to presidential politics.
Still to come, we sit down with former New York Governor George Pataki, find out why he has already been on the airwaves in the Granite State. And our Democrat and Republican analysts talk more about the race to come and some of the other names on the Republican side and when they might officially jump into the race.
Welcome to our 115th town hall meeting here in New Hampshire. And I think we finally have a poll without a margin of error.